This is my fourth or fifth movie, I think, with Robert.
I mean, the main requirement I had was just finding materials that would reflect enough light, because I was going to have to edge light them to get... It's easier for Frank when he's drawing a comic. He can draw someone all in black and then just get a white brush and paint a white outline, and then you can see them perfectly.
And obviously you can draw things that fabrics and leathers and that sort of thing don't really do.
We have to do that with lighting, which is very tough to get an edge light on a regular material. So we have to use a highly reflective materials that in person might look a little, why is this guy so slick looking? But in the movie, you can't really notice. You just notice it picks up highlights and really defines their outline of their body and has them pop off the screen more. So she went and found all kinds of terrific materials for everything and really went off the books to see what Frank had drawn to figure out what the costume, how a costume like that would really piece together on somebody.
You do have to study it a lot. I mean, I look at everything through a black and white viewfinder, for one thing, because it's all about the value of color and not color itself. So it's just been, that's been a big challenge, is turning, you know, making the wardrobe be as big as the comic.
So she had quite a lot of fun putting these costumes together.
The costuming is one of the key things. I'm just getting Sensitivity of the movie, a very distinctive visual feel.
The outfits that she's been able to do, they're literally reflections right outside of the comic, and it's uncanny. She's just really incredible. She's so talented.
I took each character and made boards for them. It was just too much. If you try to flip through the book, there's information everywhere. So I really had to break it down into a much smaller world. So I built boards, storyboards that just had the character. You know, I didn't have any of the other characters. I just did cutouts from the books. Otherwise, it would just get too confusing. So the boards really were very helpful. Everyone has been so into the characters that, you know, we've really been able to go very close to the comic book.
Drink up. Now that's one fine-looking coat you're wearing there.
The character Marv, I told him, you know, in your story, you get three different trench coats. Pretty much everything else is the same, though. You know, he really stayed in the same shirt and the same pants. He just, you know, he would see a coat and take it.
Take it off.
What?
Fine coat like that, and you're bleeding all over it.
All right, it's all yours.
So the audience would know that he is indeed taking these coats from these other people. We just had to be really creative and come up with different styles so they look different, so it doesn't look like the same coat all the time.
That's a man's shirt, and I sure as hell it ain't one of mine.
I walked into my first wardrobe fitting, which there was only one really. She had the perfect stuff there. It was all there.
The first time we see Brittany, she's in a man's shirt, and she is drawn basically nude. But I had a lot of options, a lot of different ways that we could do that, still have the man's shirt on without her being nude underneath, because it's a very sheer shirt.
But, you know, we were working on lingerie. Really?
She wore these heels. Wow. They're like 6-inch heels. Wow. They made her 6 inches taller than she actually is.
So Shelly basically wore these massive ass-kicking shoes. I mean, these spikes could kill anybody. they were pretty priceless, very dangerous.
And she wore these things all day. We couldn't get her out of them. You know, I would say, Brittany, we need to let your feet rest. And once she was in character, she didn't want to take the shoes off. She said, no, I'll lose my stance. I'll lose my character if I take the shoes off. So by the end of the day, you can only imagine, Frank Miller actually got her bath salts for her feet to soak her feet in at the end of the day, because she was such a trooper about it.
As to the stage, Pilgrim, she's just woman.
We Which Jessica Alba, she looked like an angel. She had to wear chaps and work a rope and work guns, you know, spin the guns. And at one point she had the cowboy hat on and the ropes. And so she had to be totally comfortable within her costume. And because it was chaps, I didn't want her to ever have to think about the, I didn't want her to have to think about her wardrobe because she had so many other things going on. And we wanted, she was an angel. I mean, Nancy is the sweet girl in the stories, and so there was a real fine line there of trying to make the costume sexy without going too far or not going far enough. I mean, the character Gail is literally in belts and fishnet.
She's comfortable walking around in thigh-high leather strap stilettos with an Uzi and handcuffs.
She has shoes that come all the way up to the top of her leg, literally, with spikes and belts. And
can't put it on by yourself. Like, it's a crazy, crazy outfit, and Frank's an insane man for drawing it, but Nina's actually been able to build it.
This is her costume. It's all color-coded so that we know how to do all the buckles when we put it on the actress. And it's definitely a costume that she has to have a little bit of help to get into it.
She gave me flowers for wearing it, which I think the woman, you know, deserves a whole hotel room full of flowers because she's just really incredible. She's so talented.
I forgot how quick you are.
That was a fun character to me.
Yeah, Nina and her crew, they to me they work magic because I research the costumes that I draw and I love drawing them, but it's one thing to do something with a brush on a flat piece of paper, and another thing to take a real flesh and blood woman or man and make them look like that.
I'm always astounded by what he throws at us, but I love the challenge.
It is like having my drawings come to life. It's uncanny. But it's a little better than just that because Nina brings her own expertise, her own imagination, and she tops me a lot.
It's very exciting. I don't think anything like this has ever been done.